Hello friends, today we are going to study about design of piston. In our last lecture, we had studied about design of cylinder, right? In this design of piston, the piston is the cylindrical part of the IC engine which moves back and forth to the cylindrical bore with the help of produced or exerted gas pressure due to the combustion of fuel. The piston is the movable part of the engine and the stationary part is cylindrical head. Now what is the definition of piston? Piston is a cylindrical engine component that slides back and forth in the cylinder bore by the force produced due to the combustion process. The piston acts as a movable end of the combustion chamber, whereas the stationary part is cylindrical head. There are various piston features like piston rings, piston skirts, piston head, piston barrels, right? There are various features of piston, or you can say there are various different kind of parts piston having for the construction of piston. For the piston pin, there are various kind of pin are used to connect the connecting rod and piston together, like wrist pin and gusset pin. The piston head is the top surface of the piston which is subjected to tremendous heat and force during normal engine operation. When the engine operates or when the combustion processes start, the gas pressure, maximum gas pressure exerted due to the combustion of the fuel, is directly applied on the piston head or piston top surface, right? Next, piston pin bore is through hole in the side of the piston perpendicular to the piston travel that receives the piston pin, and the piston pin is used to connect the connecting rod with the piston. The piston pin is hollow shaft that connect the small end of the connecting rod to the piston. The skirt of the piston is the portion of the piston closest to the crankshaft that helps align the piston as it moves the cylindrical bore. The other terminology is piston ring groove. A ring groove is the recess area located around the piston that is used to retain a piston ring. The groove means the recess area which is located at the top of the piston periphery. There are number of piston grooves are there, like number 3 or 4, which is used to retain a piston rings like compression ring or oil ring. Compression ring is used to reduce the wear or reduce the direct contact of cylindrical inner surface to the piston, and the oil ring is used for to protect the oil leakages. The ring lengths are two parallel surfaces on the ring grooves which function as sealing surface of the piston rings. This is basically important for the oil rings, which is used to protect or which is used to remove the leakages of oil. A piston ring is an expandable split ring used to provide seal between cylinder wall and piston. Now we are move the design part of the piston. So first we have to study about the function of the piston. What is the important function of the piston? The piston main function is must contain the cylinder pressure which is produced due to the combustion of fuel or which is exerted by the flue gases. Transmit power created by combustion to the connecting rod. This is the also another important function of piston, to transmit power which is created or which is generated during the combustion of fuel, right? To provide a place for oil control and compression ring to locate it. So this oil control rings and compression rings are located at the grooves, means the top surface, top periphery of the pistons where the grooves are located. where oil compressor control ring and compression rings are located. So three main functions of the pistons are must contain the cylinder pressure, transmit power created by combustion to the connecting rod, and provide a place for oil control and compression rings to locate. Now there are various considerations, there are various requirements of piston design, like material characteristics or property of material which is required to select the material for piston. So the first properties of the material used for piston is piston must be rigid enough to deform under the tremendous pressure and force encountered. Right, the piston must be rigid enough to not deform under tremendous pressure. When the flue gas is pressured the piston, or when the gas maximum gas pressure exerted due to the flue gases, then the material should not be deformed or should not be break. Material must be rigid enough to not deform under tremendous pressure which is exerted due to the flue gases. The next, piston material must be ductile enough to absorb the pressure peak and not shatter. Right, when the thrust force exerted on the piston valve, it should not be bent. It should not be bent or absorb all the pressure energy. When the peak means when the maximum pressure exerted on the piston, then all the energy should be absorbed by the piston material and not be shattered. Retain the proper shape under the extreme temperature and counter. When the combustion process is occurred inside the cylinder, then the high temperature produced inside the cylinder. During this extreme temperature pressure, when the extreme temperature process or during this extreme temperature time, the material should not be changed their shape, or material retain its proper shape. The main design consideration is material used for piston is aluminium. Basically, there are various different kind of material are used for piston, like cast aluminium, forged aluminium, right? Today onwards, gray cast iron is also used, or you can say it's a graphite. The graphite is being tested, but the results are not properly executed, so it is not used yet. So the basically used material is aluminium. So the main design consideration or main property is, when you are designing the piston, the proper clearance must be provided for the free piston movement. If you provide the insufficient clearance, it causes the piston to seize the cylinder, right? If you provide the more clearance, then it should cause the leakages of oil from the cylinder. So this is the main design consideration. The proper clearance must be provided for the free piston movement. Now there are different kind of material are used to make a piston, like cast iron used in very old engine, right? Today commonly used is a cast aluminium. Next, forged aluminium, carbon graphite is being tested, but result are not executed, so it is not used yet. And the design consideration are, now for the design of piston we have to solve or we have to evaluate number of terminology, like top land B1, other land, width of other land B2, thickness of grooves T2, T1, piston barrel or length of skirts, right? Other terminology of the piston we have to evaluate for the design of the piston. So first terminology or first factor is thickness of piston head, TH. We have to calculate TH, thickness of piston head, according to the Grashof's formula. It is given by TH is equal to under root 3P d square divided by 16 sigma t, right? Or based on heat transfer thickness of piston. During the combustion process, there are the maximum temperature is gained inside the cylinder. So we have to calculate the thickness of piston head, which is required for the piston on based heat transfer, right? We have to find both value according to the Grashof formula TH and based on heat transfer thickness TH, and whatever the value is greater, we have to take, right? Means we have to take the greater value, which is according to the Grashof or based on heat transfer. Now, based on heat transfer thickness of piston, TH is equal to H divided by 12.56 K multiplied TC minus TE, where H is the heat transfer, total heat generated during the combustion process. H is equal to C into HCV multiply M multiply brake power. Now, the piston rings. The image which is shown in the picture is piston ring. The gap between the piston axial thickness and radial thickness are there. When we have to design the piston rings for the piston, we have to calculate the thickness of radial thickness of piston ring and axial thickness of piston rings. Also, we have to find the top land, other land, right? So first, radial thickness and axial thickness of the piston ring. Radial thickness T1 is equal to D multiplied with under root 3PW divided by sigma T, and axial thickness T2 is equal to capital D divided by 10 NR, where NR is number of rings. Now, width of top land. The width of top land is generally taken as TH to 1.2 TH, and width of other land generally taken as 0.75 T2 to T2. Now, there should be gap between free ends of ring. Why we have to given the gaps between free end? Because of the exact fitting or exact landing on the grooves of the piston, we should give the gap between free ends of the rings, and is given by 3.5 T1 to 4 T1. Now, next, maximum thickness of the piston barrel can be obtained from the equation T3 is equal to 0.03 capital D plus B plus 4.5 mm, where D is the radial depth of the piston rings groove, which is taken as 0.4 mm. Now, the side thrust of the connecting rod acts on the below portion of the piston from the rings is known as piston skirts. The above portion where the grooves are made on the piston periphery is the top area of the piston, but below of that portion, below of the piston rings area, the portion of the piston is called as the piston skirt, right? At there, the thrust force applied by the connecting rod on the piston and the length of skirt should be such that the bearing pressure should not be exceeded 0.25 Newton per mm square of the projected area. Now, the side thrust generally usually taken as the 10th part of a maximum gas pressure which is exerted due to the flue gases. So capital R is equal to P by 10, and the gas pressure is generally taken as pi d square by 4. So also side thrust is also given by, also calculated based on the bearing pressure which is occurs or which is produced due to the bearing or piston pin, right? So radial thrust or sorry side thrust R is equal to PB into D, capital D is bore of the cylinder into L, where L is the length of skirt. Now the next portion is the total length of piston. Why? Because the we have calculated the length of skirt, top length, other length, the gap between piston rings or piston rings, axial thickness, we have calculated thickness of head calculated. So now the total length of piston which is required to for design is given by L is equal to length of skirt plus length of ring section plus length of top length, piston pin. Now the final and last portion of the design of piston is piston pin. The importance of piston pin is the strength of piston pin is taken as less than all other kind of component which are used in piston, right? Why? Because when the force is generated more than calculated force or more than the ultimate stress, then what happened? That pin is going to break, right? Pin is going to fail, but other components which are used in piston are saved. So the strength of the piston pin is taken as the lesser than other components which are used in piston. Now when we are going to design the piston pin, the gudgeon pin and wrist pin are used generally for the vehicle. Now loads on the piston due to the gas pressure is taken as pi d square by 4 into P, and load on the piston pin due to the bearing pressure and bearing load is taken as bearing pressure into bearing area, which is PB1 into DO into L1, and the figure which is shown a piston pin which is locked with the help of circlip, and the use of piston pin is to connect the piston with the connecting rod or with the small end of the connecting rod. Now if the force, suppose the force P is exerted on the top surface of the piston or top surface of the connecting rod, and the length L1, L2 is denoted on the figure. So what happened? The pressure is distributed on the all surfaces. So the L2 is equal to L1 plus D minus L1 by 2 equal to L1 plus D by 2. Now for the maximum bending moment which is produced on the connecting rod, or you can say the connecting pin, means piston pin, is capital M is equal to P by 2 into L by L2 by 2 minus P by L1 into L1 by 2 into L1 by 4. Solving this equation, we can find the P capital M is equal to PD by 8. Now the piston pin is made hollow, right? Piston pin is made hollow. So the section modulus Z is taken as pi by 32 DI raised to 4 minus DO raised to 4 divided by DO. And we know that bending moment or bending stress sigma B is equal to M by Z. Okay, and with the help of this we can find the bending stress sigma B, and the value which is getting with the help of this equation should be less than the ultimate stress which is given in the example, right? If the value is lesser than the ultimate stress, then our design of piston is safe. or else if we'll find the value of sigma b or value of bending stress is greater than the ultimate stress, then our design, which is calculated during the process, is going to fail. We have to find other calculations data, or we have taken other assumptions to design our pistons. Clear? This is our last portion. At the last, whenever you design the piston, you have to check whether the bending stress is less than this ultimate stress or greater than the ultimate stress, else you will fail your design. Thank you. If any problem, then you can ask me at the end of lecture.